kind to be taking my time in a place that's worth a damn. And today's another day that I've gone and thrown away, and I don't care.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Backyard Madness. And tonight the show is kicking off with a rematch between UPW's very own Mr. Thief, the UPW International Champion, going one-on-one with ETW's very own Mr. Too Good. And Mr. Too Good dancing away. This all started at Elite Mania 3, where these two first collided with Mr. Thief, coming on the short end of the stick, losing to Mr. Thief. And clearly that cannot sit right with Mr. Thief, so at Burnout attacking Mr. Thief, and on UPW calling Mr. Too Good out and expressing his hatred and his reasoning for attacking Mr. Too Good. And now they collide in the present day, and you can see Mr. Thief there poking his head out, and there's Mr. Thief.
Ew.
And Mr. Too Good getting verbal against Mr. Thief, and these two, well, I'm assuming gotta bring themselves to something of a war. And now the match begins, and Mr. Too Good getting ready to fight, same with Mr. Thief. These guys go out for the second time, and oh, Mr. Thief allowing Mr. Too Good to take the first shot and just gets rocked. And another one just rocks Mr. Thief. Mr. Thief can't do many, take many of those and replies with one back. And now, Mr. Thief getting him up, knees him in the midsection, dropping Mr. Too Good. And now they're also doing this in the indoor arena. And now attacking him with lefts and rights. And now Mr. Thief with a boot.
Oh no.
Knocking Mr. Too Good almost out of the arena. No. Knees him in the midsection. These two got to take it out on a hip toss from Mr. Thief. And no, drop kick. Big drop kick from Mr. Thief, bringing the fight, letting all of that aggression out on Mr. Too Good. But Mr. Too Good's got to fight back. And now Mr. Too Good's getting him in.
Yes.
Daniel Bryan. Shoulder attack.
Come on, get
the... Going with the yes chance. Yes. And it appears Mr. Too Good is gonna be, you know, going off two shoulder tackles. I think I know who Mr. Too Good is trying to be. Mr. Thief swings the and misses, gets ducked under, and then a moment for John Cena. Yes. And Mr. Thief trying to get away. But Mr. Too Good's not allowing it.
You can't see me.
Mr. Too Good's going. And no, misses. Mr. Thief got out the way in time. Could not complete the five knuckle shuffle. And now Mr. Thief getting Too Good up. And now going to go for a suplex. Can we see it here? Mr. Thief with a suplex to Too Good. Now Mr. Thief getting up and being very quick with the movements to kick out.
I refuse to stay down.
Mr. Too Good not wanting to stay down. Mr. Thief has got to try and change that. And as we see here,
cat. You're my life savior now.
The cat was possibly Mr. Too Good's savior, but the cat runs off as Mr. Thief pulls him away. And a leg drop from the top. Taking out Mr. Too Good. Mr. Thief, not wasting any time, getting back up. Splash! Huge splash from Mr. Thief. Getting up Mr. Too Good. And now, going to pick him up for a fireman's carry. No. Yes. And Mr. Thief collapses. And Mr. Too Good cannot get his footing. But gonna get up now. And now, gonna pick him up.
I love you, John Cena.
And attitude adjustment. Mr. Thief's foot collides with the roof. Two. Mr. Thief kicks out of the attitude adjustment. Mr. Too Good is not happy. And now, gonna get him for a uranage. Mr. Too Good, where is he learning all this? You know what, maybe...
Like a Nacho Libre.
Okay, this is the Mr. Too Good I'm used to. Nacho Libre, no! Mr. Thief caught him. But Mr. Too Good's got to fight still. And now, gonna get hit. And then, what are we gonna see here? Ducks the line. Ducks the clothesline. Punches him in the face. Mr. Thief stumbling. Gets kicked now. And now Mr. Too Good has got him in.
Come on.
Oh, the cat is back. The cat, the solid steel cat to the face. Don't worry, the cat's running off. The cat's all good. It's solid steel after all. The solid steel cat to the face of Mr. Thief. And wait, Mr. Thief! RKO! RKO from Mr. Thief. By God. 1, 2, 3. And your winner is Mr. Thief. The solid steel cat is not taking him out today. Welcome to the next match of Backyard Madness. Now we are going to see a triple threat match. It is YBW's very own cross-country talent, Echo, who we have all seen before in ETW, a former Havoc champion, saying that this is his match as he thrives on triple threats. And winning the Havoc title is a perfect example of that. Next up, it is ETW's own Hunter, looking for gold in this company. It is the Japanese beast, Kimono. And Kimono being in the company since Elite Mania 2 has had some great opportunities, but just unfortunately can't get the job done. But can tonight change that all? There's Kimono making his way to the ring. The Hunter getting right in the face of Echo, like he did at Elite Mania 3. And oh, Echo shoves him away. A bit of tension since Elite Mania 3 that these two can get out on each other. And now we wait for the ETW Revolutionary Champion, the ETW Immortalized Briefcase Holder, and FWA World Champion, FWA's Justin Page. And like I said, he is unstoppable. He has all the momentum in the world. And there is Justin Page coming out with a brand new shirt. Unstoppable Justin Page, that explains it perfectly. Holding the Revolutionary title and the FWA World title. And now, Justin gonna put both titles down as these three are about to go at it. And the bell has been rung. And oh, Kimono attacking Echo straight away. The champion. See, he wants none of this. He's just going to let them fight. Save that energy. And now Kimono going to have his attention to... Oh, Paige gets kicked. Falls down and gets dragged from Paige. That pure power. And oh, Justin cleaning house, taking out Echo. And with the shoe again. It's just whacks him with a shoe. We saw it happen last time when that happened. Azrael had a mark on his back. And Kimono seems to position himself to a dive. Taking him out. Oh, it appears Kimono tried to kick him in the midsection. But kicks him straight in the balls. Justin's been... Well, that's one way to take out the big guy. Kimono's got to focus his attention on Echo. And the big guy's up to try and defend his title. Throwing Echo and taking him out. Super kick to the midsection, keeping Kimono down. But the Hunter going to try and fight. And try to throw something at him, but Paige has caught him. And Paige got him with a choke. And now Echo and Paige teaming up before Paige gives him a two chops and a shoulder from Echo. And now Kimono gonna try and... Oh, a headbutt from both of them. Oh, gets taken out. Headbutt to the back of the head. And now Echo seems to stumble but has been taken out. And Justin Paige gonna focus his attention. Gonna go for a body slam. Body slam caught. Rana. Oh, to a spear. What a maneuver between these three. Body slam was caught to the Rana. To the spear. It appears that was all a coincidence. But these three. Oh, what the. What is Kimono having? Minor knee to the face. Gonna be taking out Echo. And now Kimono gonna be choking out Echo. And Paige gonna try and fight for his title. But Kimono is taking everyone out. And now Kimono flexing. And then coffin drop! Coffin drop onto both Justin Paige and Echo. I did not expect that to come out of nowhere. And knees Justin. One, two. And Paige seems to break it up. And Paige is fighting. You know that back will be aching. It's being shown here, but Paige is still going to try and get up to fight and defend the title. Kicking Echo. Echo's just down and out. And now, perhaps getting thrown now. And Echo's still getting hit in the crossfire, and he's not even trying to do anything. And now Paige going to get Kimono up. And now Paige, powerbomb to Kimono. And now, one, two, and a kick out from Kimono. He kicked out of the powerbomb, somehow finding a way to keep on going. And now, Kimono got to jump over, and Paige is out. One last lie from Echo onto Paige via Kimono's body. And now Echo taking control in this match. Stomping Kimono, taking Kimono out. But Kimono fights back. Echo with a shoulder. And Kimono says, bring it. And then Kimono faking him out. And oh, takes him out with a headlock driver. And a knee straight to the face. Kimono is just a hunter unleashed. One, two. And he's done it. Kimono has done it. He's finally won gold. Kimono is the new ETW Revolutionary Champion. The Hunter has finally done it. What a victory to Kimono. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we go to the Havoc Championship match. Bane and Pyro go at it for a second time on ETW grounds. And possibly this time, the outcome will be different. And we await FWA's very own Bane to debut and make his way to the ring. Bane's first match in ETW. What a way to join. Like Azrael facing Pyro for the Havoc title. And now think about it, the last three people Bane has had to defend the title against has been FWA talent. And Pyro seems to be the unstoppable monster it is. And can that still continue with this defense? First it was Azrael. Next it was Demon, and now Bane. And Pyro looking big as ever, as these two raging bulls are gonna fight once more. And Pyro standing up there to look more powerful and more dominant than Bane, but Bane wasn't fazed, and the match has begun. Pyro and Bane go for a lockup. These two are not gonna hold back, and Pyro appears to be overpowering the strongman Bane, but Bane gonna be fighting up, using that strength to get back into a good position. But Pyro looks to be walking around, but no, Bane coming back and both breaking it. That looks to have taken a bit more out of Bane compared to Pyro. But Bane getting up and now going for a big dive onto Pyro. Massive. And now here comes Bane, and immediately a kick out from Pyro. And Bane with a pole, whacking it, wailing it on Pyro's back. Not wasting any time to try and grab the weapons, using the Havoc stipulation to Bane's advantage. But Pyro catches the pole and smacks it on the head of Bane. And then Bane with a big kick, sending Pyro away. And now Bane gonna go for a leg drop. Flawless. An incredible leg drop. And now Bane gonna go for something again here. Going for a flipping oh. Bane misses the mark. Didn't get anything, but that is not phase the strongman. Bane now gonna be grabbing. Oh, Pyro tries to fight, and oh, with the fan lid, hitting it on Pyro and throwing it away. Pyro with a right hand to Bane. The monster wasting no time. Big headbutt. Sends Bane down. And now Bane pushes Pyro back. And now Bane up to his feet. Now Pyro going with big knees. Huge knees to the face. That was incredible. And now looks to have a chokehold or a sleeper in. Or half Nelson, full Nelson, a full Nelson in now. And it's got Pyro wrapped his legs around Pyro the monster. That this could potentially be the match. But then Pyro gonna try and fight out of it. Gotta be trying to fight and wait. Here's a cover. Bane has to let go. Bane didn't realize. But Pyro almost won the match. just like that. Now, Burnham's standing up. Oh, gets caught with a boot. Pyro now getting up to its feet. And now Bane going to be picking him up. Picks up Pyro, slams him. Big maneuver, proving why Bane is the strong man. And now Bane gonna grab a chair. And now Bane gonna slam it. No, missed. Pyro got out the way. And oh, Pyro, a shot to the face. And now Pyro the headbutt. Not done with Bane, headbutt. And Bane with a forearm, headbutt back to Pyro. And now Pyro grabbing that chair. And Bane's up. Chair thrown in the face of Bane. And Bane falls. And now Pyro going to pick up Bane. Getting Bane up. And now Pyro gonna have Bane set up. And a big suplex, taking Bane out. Huge suplex. And now Pyro's got that chair. Chair to the face. Taking out Bane. The strongman not looking good. And Bane's caught the chair lip. And, oh, pushing Pyro back. And now Bane going to pick Pyro up. And a spine buster, no. Does not happen. It does not happen, the spine buster. Wait, Bane's got to pick him up, though. Spine buster. Bane digging deep to hit that. Two. No. Pyro kicks out. Could not put Pyro away. And now Bane gonna have to go and get the monster up again. Big clothesline hit from Bane, and Pyro is out. Now Bane gonna be working on the head of Pyro some more. Moving out the way, Bane's trying to do anything and everything he can to win the Havoc title. And oh, a boot, but missed. And now Pyro whacking the back of Bane with it. Oh, whacked again, but Bane caught it. And Bane trying to push, but Pyro gonna be stomped in. And stomping the midsection over and over again. And now Pyro gonna throw that away. Gonna be picking Bane up. And oh, big right hand. Gonna get the fan lid, whacking it across the head of Bane. A lockup between Pyro and Bane. And Bane with a big knee. Big knee again. And Bane with a big uppercut. Big hand to take out Pyro. And now Bane's going up. And Pyro moving that chair away. Not wanting a bar of it. But Bane comes with a big kick. Folding Pyro inside out. And now Bane grabbing the chair. Trying to move around and position that. Bane got to pick up Pyro. Bane might have something in mind to take him out. Throwing Pyro away on the trampoline. Getting Pyro up. And Pyro with a big right to the midsection. Axe handle to the back. And now Pyro's gonna look for a choke slam. Like we've saw at Elite Mania. The choke slam off the trampoline. Can he do that again on that chair? Pyro's got him. Can Pyro do it? Choke slam, no. Bane got out of it. And now going for a sidewalk slam. Held him up to prove that he is stronger than Pyro. And now Bane picking Pyro up. And then a hip toss on the chair. Off the trampoline. A big hip toss. And Pyro can be out of it. That could be the match. One, two, no! Pyro's reign as Havoc champion continues. Pyro can't be put down. And now Bane doesn't even know what to do. Attacking the midsection of Pyro. Looking for a spinebuster. And now Pyro sits up. The monster sits up now. And Bane is struggling to fight. To get some energy to attack him. Gets kicked. He was going to swing at Pyro, but not successful at all. Pyro now picking up Bane. And Pyro is going to look for a choke slam here. And here it is. Choke slam DDT. DDT from Bane. Now going to pick Pyro up. Going to use the opportunity to Bane's advantage. Going to go for a tombstone pile driver. Tombstone, no! Pyro reverses it! And now Pyro gotta go for the tombstone! The tombstone pile driver has been hit. Can this be the match? One, two, and it is! Pyro retains the Havoc Championship! You can see Pyro struggling, but in the end, Pyro remains champion.
I promise I won't keep you long. I'll keep you forever.
Being one of the fastest rising stars in ECW. So, as a reward for him being one of the fastest rising stars, I have decided to give him an opportunity for the ECWA Elite Championship. So he will take on Mute for the Elite title. Stay tuned because that match is going to be a banger.
And now it's main event time. We await the rookie Azriel from FWA to come in here for the biggest opportunity in his life, going after the top prize in Australian Backyard Wrestling today, the ETW Elite Championship. And Azriel is looking ready. And now we await the Vigilante Mute. There he is, the champion. With a brand new shirt, mind you. Mute making his way to the ring. And these two, this could be an absolute slobber knocker between the two of them. A hard hitting match as that bell's about to ring. And now that's rung, all these two getting straight into it. And immediately the mind games play. And Azriel clearly showing the strength advantage, trying to get into the head of Mute. And Mute's taking him out, putting out frustrations. Oh, a big shot to the face. Another big shot to the face. And now Azriel gonna go for something. No, Mute attacking him and gets him back. And now Mute gonna look for Azriel to get up. Gonna look to get up. And then suicide dive. Oh, boot to the face. Mute stumbling. Azriel punching him in the head repeatedly. These two wasting no time. A kick, but Mute caught him. And then attacking him, gets up. And now gonna bring Azriel down. What is Mute gonna do? Big kick to the face. Big drop kick. And now Mute going to attack the face. But Azriel goes with a shot. And now immediately is in control, bashing the face, wasting no time. And now gonna be putting pressure on that arm, stomping it. Stomping the arm. Now, Azriel could be working on that arm again. Oh, stomps it again. And now, Azriel gonna go get me. Oh, wrenching that arm and yoinking him down. Just throwing Mute. The Elite Champion not looking good at all. Now Azriel going back to that arm, working it. Gonna have a
How is this man?
Hammerlock and a sleeper. Wrenching that up.
He's weak.
Azriel could very easily break the arm of Mute. The Elite Champion needs to get back in this. And wait! Twist of Fate, no! Yeah, it's pulled! Into the big drop kick to the back. The Vigilante coming back into this match. Azriel getting too cocky as always. And if he's not careful, that could lead him to his downfall like his other two matches. And no. Azriel attacking Mute, back in control. And then Azriel got him up for a fireman's carry. What are we going to see here? F5! A big F5! That just took Mute out. And now Azriel going to attack Mute. Slamming the back of his head into the mat and punching him in the face. And now going back to that arm. Working on it. And now Azriel gonna, oh, twist that ankle, gonna work on the leg, stopping that run up for a claymore, attacking the leg. Mute is being picked apart tonight. Azrael wasting no time. Gotta be working on every body part. Azrael showboating, and this is a time where if I was him, I would try to keep going onto mute. Waste no time with the Vigilante. He is the elite champion for a reason. And now Azrael, twist of fate. No. He didn't go for it. Did not go for it that time. So you just... This is what I mean. He needs to stop getting ahead of himself because things like this could happen. And Mute, trying to fight, but no, gets cut off from Azrael. And now Azrael, twist of fate again, no. Mute attacking him. Attacking the midsection, going for knees. And now Mute, DDT. Big DDT from the Vigilante. And a leg drop to the midsection. And now Mute, slamming his Azrael's head. Mute really trying. Oh, gets kicked. It's kicked in the leg again. Azrael in control. No, Mute tries to take him out, but Azrael doesn't let it happen. Curb stomp! Curb stomp from Azrael. That could be the match. He's not going for the pin. Why? Why? That was your moment right there. He hit the curb stomp and attacking the back of the legs. And attacking the arm again. He had a perfect opportunity. Slamming his head into the mat now. Azrael, that ruthless aggression. And now going to work on that arm and got to be trying to pull it out of the socket. And oh, Mute goes with a fit back fist to break out of it. Now the Vigilante will be aching right now. Gonna try and kick him. Oh, gets kicking Azrael. And now Mute gonna go and get Azrael up. And wait, what does Mute gotta go for? Silencer! He hits a silencer. An old move of his returning to take Azrael out, the champion. We haven't seen him pull that out for over a year. A silencer has been hit, and Azrael punches him in the face trying to fight. And now I'm Mute. What's he going for? Breaking the silence! Breaking the silence has been hit, and now Mute going for the cover. 1, 2, 3! And Mute is still the elite champion. Azrael, unfortunately, coming up short. And you can see Mute struggling now after getting beaten and battered. We hope you will enjoy, and we will see you. Wait, what? That's Canox! That's Canox from FWA. How'd he get in the building? We've seen him before on ETW over a year ago. Azrael's up and Canox is there. Curb stop from Canox. And Canox attacking him, and so is Azrael. And oh no. It all makes sense now. I can't believe this. This is a robbery. This is a robbery to Mute. Oh, gets hit with a case. Is Justin gonna cash in? This is three FWA guys. And now, Canox and Azrael gonna pick Mute up. And now triple power bomb. And the bell's been rung. He's cashing in. 2, 3. Justin is new elite champion. He lost the revolutionary title earlier tonight. This is a robbery. This is planned. I thought I was real and Justin Hate. Wait. Wyatt! It's the Hall of Famers! It's Stryker! Stryker's back! He's back in ETW! And Azrael are going to try and take him out. But now Stryker with a chair. The steel meeting the body of Azrael and Kenox. Azrael realizes and is leaving immediately. Stryker saving his best friend. Get these FWA scum away. Stryker is back. I never thought he would come back, but he has. And Mute realizing he is no longer elite champion, but Stryker is here. And what could this mean for the future of ETW?